A very good afternoon to all the respected to the respected chairperson and all the honorable jury members. Myself Pratika Mishra, I am a forensic expert as well as a graphologist working on the handwriting samples of person. Now today I came up with a very I just want to connect my study with the psychology, so it is my ongoing work which I am working on, and these are the danger signs in handwriting and signatures. So today I am going to represent my study on how to detect or aware with the danger signs one can analyze through an individual handwriting or a signature of a person. With this I want to share a very important information. Handwriting signature is being one of the individual characteristics of a person, that a person is having his own individual graphics of writing. Now with this word, I would like to convey one more information, that handwriting is being a neuromuscular task, that is the control and coordination of brain with the muscles which give the outcome of your handwriting. So whenever we are saying handwriting, we are not saying basically handwriting, we are saying brain writing. So with the word brain writing means whatever which is in your brain is shown in the graphics of your handwriting and signature. So I still want to continue with this as a graphology. Graphology is basically used to analyze these handwriting graphics for the analysis of a personality of a person and reveal the hidden characteristics of a person. So if I am saying handwriting, I am saying I am going to reveal the characteristics of a person on the basis of the graphics of handwriting. But if I am saying I want to present a person's public image, then I will definitely look for the signatures, because signatures is being the appearance of the public image and handwriting is what you actually are. Now with this, I have came to some of the very rare and uncommon structures which I have covered in my study work. Now coming to my study work, as we all know that graphology are still running and still being an embryonic field in the deception of the personality analysis and considered as the way of personality through the graphics. Now as we all know, the criminals or the offenders, they are not the born criminals, they are not the born offenders. So the circumstances, the upbringings, the environment, the belongings, they all are the one which itself it create a criminal and an offender. Moving to my study work, I have some of the structures mentioned in my poster which is having some graphic representation. Coming to the very first handwriting character, that is the two white space. So we see there are numerous handwritings which is having a very nominal. So we basically create spacing into three different categories, that is a normal space, a quite wide space and a narrow space. Now we have seen a very wide space which is not very consistent to the entire writing but still showing some reference. So with this I want just a second. Yeah. So if you see, if I'm speaking about a two white space, I am saying that the writer, whenever leave a two white space, they might have a possibility that they show the personality analysis, that is it represent a betray, dishonesty and lie. Now why I'm saying this thing? Now I'm saying this thing with the logic point behind it. So whenever you create a gap, whenever you create gap in anything, whenever you pause in anything, whenever you state a gap in any conversation, it itself create a little of doubt, a little of dishonesty, a little of liar. So as you all know that the offenders, the criminals, they have this quality in it that being a liar, being a dishonest, because they want to disguise their real personality and want to reveal as the offensive behavior of their personality. Now coming to my next character, we have seen some of the uncommon structure, that is a creation of a spoon-like E. Now spoon-like E is defined as the uncommon structure again. Now in this we have found analysis which represent the false color of correctness, or you can say a cautious behavior. So we all know that our mind run with three basic things, that is the conscious behavior, the subconscious and the unconscious behavior. Now our life is completely running with these three phases of life. Now there are the monotonous thing which is running unconsciously and subconsciously with our state of mind, but then there is a characteristic which is conscious. So whenever we are doing any offensive behavior, when I am doing any behavior which is not acceptable, our mind become little conscious, unless and until it is not recovering to the mental disability and any mental disorder, yes of course. Then these spoony structure comes with the evasive, caggy, and a shrewd behavior. Also, they will look with a very true, pleasant face, but then they will hide something which is very brutal for their personality. We came across a very intellectual sign when we are dealing with the different handwriting and signature samples. So basically, in the graphology, when we used to analyze the handwriting or signature of a person, we take the 80% sample of the handwriting and then we request the three signature to compare both the characteristics. As we all know, handwriting itself is one of the individual characteristics, same as to the signature. Now, when we are talking about a gap between the handwriting and signature, there are numerous persons who move with the motive that the public image is different and the personal image is different. So when a person is showing a vast deviation between the handwriting and signature, between the personal and the public image, they are not typically a sign of a liar or a criminal, but then at the same time, they can differ their personality. And when they are differing their personality, there might be the possibility that the outcome can be the possibility of a danger sign whenever it's going to be happened in any manner. Now we have a very interesting part, which we have studied in our research work. That is the felon's claw. You all have heard about the felon's claw in your study work. Now, this felon's claw in graphology basically is seen in the lower zone letter. So, as we all know, the writing follows three zones: the upper zone, the middle zone, and the lower zone. So, when we are talking about the lower zone letters, that we see some of the lower zone characteristics, just like Y, a small G, a small J. So, they show a twisted against the natural way. So whenever naturally our G will go to the direction of the right side, but when you see an outward and a backstab direction or a twisted against direction in a Y, G and any type of words, then they are the felon's claw. They basically define the unconscious guilt, or they also define the punished unconsciously. So they have the unconscious guilt, like a self-blaming nature, taking things on their own way. So we have studied in numerous criminal writings, these felon's claw is being a very frequently used writing appearance. Then we are coming to the maniac D. Now when I'm talking about the maniac D, I would like to connect you with the very serial killer, very famous serial killer, the Zodiac Killer. Now if I tell you about the Zodiac Killer in a very short, these Zodiac killers are basically the self-proclaimed directly like to be they are involved in a 5 murders in a Northern California, and he itself taught police and made threats through their writing. So they circulate threats through the writing, anonymous writing samples and all these things. And they used to publish the threats in the newspapers around 1969 and 1974 of year. So in the very particular writing sample of the maniac D, if you see the D, if you just focus on the D part of it, so you see the slant, the writing slant, the individual letter slant is moving away, is showing, like normally it is showing the bended nature. Now this is the example where the person is having a sudden uncontrolled behavior. Now this sudden uncontrolled behavior is a conclusion where a person can immediately or a sudden represent a very unacceptable behavior which might be the outcome of an offensive behavior. And this have been visualized under the Zodiac Killer writing. This has been visualized under the Ted Bundy writing sample as well. And this has been visualized in one of a very famous serial killer who has been involved in the Ramsey notes. So they have also mentioned these type of writing which a kidnapper threatened by kidnapping a small girl. So these writing sample has been analyzed where we have come to the conclusion of a maniac D feature as well. Now there are another characteristics which detail about the double and triple loop. So usually if you see the people are not following much about the double and triple loop. So curving the more loops in the ones, it signifies the secretiveness. Now when you roll and roll and roll, I am just giving a very simple example. When we simply confused with something, when we simply secretive with something, we just simply roll our hears and we just it shows a very different behavior. So this we have analyzed in the writing sample as well. In the writing sample, we come across a double and a triple loop in the middle zone writing, like O, like A, and similarly like B as well. So whenever there is a twisted turn oval writing, so we see this oval circulations and a double and a single loop writings again. Coming to the stabs in ovals. Now, stabs in ovals, there are numerous alphabets, the small alphabets, where the stabbing feature is seen. Stabbing is simply the back stab, the back movement. When you are forming a loop, a zero, like if you see in the A letter, in the D letter, in the G letter, in the Q letter. In the inner circle of the oval, there is a backstab. Now that backstab writing is called where the individual letter implies the liar facet, the liar things. And they are the one who like called as the forked tongue that defend that whatever they say, they don't commit on their basis. So I would like to conclude my study by telling that this is my ongoing study work and I am working on it by taking the referencing part. And I have done my referencing while I studied on the Jacobi in the H.C. Jacobi, who was a very famous graphologist, and he worked in 1948 in his book, and the page number it's around 238. He discussed about the handwriting of a juvenile offenders, and he actually detailed according to the handwriting sampling. He actually worked on the numerous cases where he discussed what are the characteristics, what are the behavior, what are the individual signs which showing that person might be offensive, what might be show some offensive behavior in their future life. Also, there in the same book, the page number around 261, we have studied about the graphology with the connection of criminology. So the psychological behavior, it's being interlinked between this graphology and this criminology psychological behavior. So there are the numerous characteristics. We are keep on working on those characteristics. We are telling of the positive and the dominant traits, and then we are also discussing about the negative traits as well. There is also one of my research work which I have been published, and where I have worked on the signature samples, the public image of the person, and I have taken an equal quantity of male and a female sample and reveal the dominancy of the character. Also, to justify my study, I had worked on some of the domestic violence persons who, like, of course, I cannot get the writing directly, but I just take the non-requested samplings. And on the basis of the non-requested sampling, I encountered many of the characteristics, of course, justifying the numerous study taken by the graphologist in their work. So this is all in my study work. And though we have selected the criteria of asking the questions in the last, I'll be happy for the suggestions and the questions.